Hello friends, welcome to bispsolutions.com. My name is Ali. So this is again going to be a series of videos for HFM, Hyperion Financial Management Aspiring Tool. So in my previous videos, I have explained about consolidation of ownership and non-controlling interest. But what happened when you own an entity 10% previously, but now you increase it to 70%? Right, so you need to adjust. You need to adjust the investment in subsidiaries. So equity pickup basically adjustment. So we need to pick the equity. In the proper definition, we can say the equity pickup is a method of re-evaluating the investments owned by a holding company. So you need to realize changes in equity. So there are some example here. Example of equity pickup adjustment, like when direct ownership, right now you know that previously you hold 10%, now it's increased. So direct ownership, then direct ownership with translation. Translation means when you there is a changes in a different currency, like one entity or subsidiary is in US and the parent company is in UK. So how they translate into local, then cascading ownership and subholdings. Like suppose that H hold A, but A also hold by B. So first of all, we need to hold from B to A, then A to H. Then we'll check it in example proper. Then this is a cross ownership. A hold B. B also holds some part of A. So this is a cross ownership. So we'll check this in the example here in Excel. First of all, the direct ownership. So suppose the BISP is a parent company, hold DGBOs 80%, and historical investment of BISP in DG is 100. Now the actual equity of DG is 1000. So we need to check the 80% of 1000, like we can check it, 1000, 80%, it's become 800. So the adjustment amount, that we know the previous adjustment is historical cost is 80, now it's become the 800. So how much amount we need to adjust? So for example, that 80%, 800 minus 100 is 70. 100, 700 is need to be adjusted. So investment in DGBOs. So if it is a EP, equity pickup, or you are adjusting the equity pickup, so it will be impact both assets as well as the equity. Like assets also increase and equity also increase both the side. So investment in DGBOs is 700 debit and equity is credit 700. So we'll go for the next and we'll check the previous adjustment, because we need to eliminate or we need to offset the historical cost in local currency showing in the actual value of the equity owned now. So what we need to do is we need to check for previously. For example, here I have a previous or before the adjustment balance sheet of BISP. Investment in DG, where the investment in DG is 100, this is a previous cost, and other assets is 1900. Total is become the 2000. Of course, the same time the increase, the equity is the same, 2000, 2000. So how much we need to adjust? We need to adjust 700, because 100 is already adjusted. It was historic. So 700 need to be adjusted. So how we adjust the same thing here? So investment in DG, is now become the 800 plus 700 is 100. Previous one is become the 800. The other assets is also the same, remain the same, 1900. It's now the total is increased by 2700, where it was at 2000. So 700 gets listed here. And liability side, the equity is total 2700. So in this manner, one can do the equity pickup adjustment in HFM. So we'll do the hands-on in HFM in another video. One can check. So that's all for today. If you have any queries or question, you can comment below or visit to our website www.bispsolutions.com to engage an expert. Thank you. Have a great day.